I mean, what I would think if you hadn't given me this mystery of how long this has been there, I would think a pile of cysts. But the fact that you've only had it for about a year and it's grown to this size, that's a little bit unusual. So I'm not quite sure what this is.
Right.
The best way to do this is to take it off, send it in, and just have it looked at under the microscope, okay?
Yeah.
So
great.
I'm really interested to find out what this is. All right.
Okay,
well, let's
Lord.
Get started. Yeah.
Thank you.
See you in a little bit.
Good.
Okay. I think he's got a pile of cysts. It's a little bit strange because it's only been there for a little while, but usually those occur more on the scalp, but it just has that firmness here, so I don't know. But it is right in the center of his face.
He's not the round scissors.
No.
I think
no, they
the rounded scissor would be really
what?
Nice.
Okay.
Just to be gentle, there's a lot of important.
Oh,
pieces.
Yeah, they were in one of the boxes. And, oh, I found one of your bags, I think, too, and I put it over there with the other sock shoes next to your bag.
You make sure I'm not hurting you at all, okay? You feel me pushing on you, but you should not feel anything sharp.
Well, why is she so affected my thoughts, my brain?
What?
It's true.
You need to have it checked out, because I think
I believe it.
You lying.
I believe it.
She's just trying to make sure
you
get
lying.
Yeah, she's a good manipulator like that.
Oh,
I mean, you see his hair?
This is going to
I see his hair.
See something peeking out already.
Yeah, they're on the pole.
It's right there, ready. Okay, give a little squeeze, okay?
All right.
Yeah. My mom done that to me before. Felicia done that to me before.
It popped your pimples.
Oh yeah, Felicia love that.
This might not be the end of the
man. I cannot.
What?
Oh yeah, she get some of the stuff.
Oh, it's done?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, police love doing this stuff.
Mr. Carter comes in.
Watch me checking my face all the time.
His forehead. It's been pretty rapidly growing. From the look of it, from the examination, I think it's a pile of cysts, but I never really know until I start working on it. Okay, I'm going to give a little squeeze, okay?
All right.
Like, this layer. Like, police love that stuff. Police actually did that to, long
some
month before.
Here. Let's see what color
and it was long just like that. Twisted. It's
by the wall of it. There's no clear-cut reason why cysts happen, but they just do, and they're fairly common. They do occur in the hair-bearing area because they're derived from the hair follicle, so you're only going to see them in areas that potentially grow hair. I'm going to squeeze too hard, or else this gets on our wall. You okay?
It's thick.
Good. I squeezed out all that cheesy content from Joe's cysts, and I've really discarded that because that's not what really counts. What counts is that sac wall. I need to remove that completely, and I'll send that off to pathology to confirm the diagnosis.
Almost
there. This looks like it's, I don't know if it's an epidermoid or a pilar cyst. I'm just checking that I got the whole thing out.
I need to start bringing, I need to bring my olive oil here.
Joe,
I don't want to spray the thing.
Either an epidermoid
or
a pilar cyst.
I have olive oil.
The shape of
it's
the sac actually
mine,
tells me
no.
That this is most likely a pilar cyst because it's thicker and it kind of retains its shape.
God damn it.
Tend to be a little thinner and more
stay, keep staying around the food.
Easily torn.
Come on. Come on.
I'm only going to get confirmation if I send it.
Come on. Damn, where you go?
It was by my eye.
Where'd it go?
All right, we're at the final stretch, though, here.
You gotta keep that out here.
A bit out here, and then we're good. All right. You are now
I don't see
cystless.
It.
Oh, man.
I think the result looks
good. I don't see anything.
Natural forehead
this is
piece,
annoying.
I think over just puffy right now. Better come down.
Like, there's ones where you just leave them on and the light attracts them and then they
just
pop sprays.
Yeah, but this one's
I
like,
give one of those.
Wow. When my wife sees it, she might say, oh, she did a good job. That's probably.
God damn it.
You might come back on food.
Okay, guys, I'm done for the day, all right? I'll see you guys later.
Come on, man.
Okay.
Look like Elmer Fudd right now.
I just have some charts.
You know. Shut up.
Damn it!
He'll come back.
That part of the reason why he wanted.
He'll come back in the middle of the stream.
Because his wife made so much fun of him. I mean,
well, I know what that can be like.
Yeah. I think you're done for the day. Let's pack it all up, and you're gonna take me out to dinner.
We'll get my best.
Love me, okay?
Yeah. Eat your dog.
Are you getting dinner or are you getting dinner?
Damn it!
You're getting dinner. I cook every other day of the week.
And it's always like right by your eyeball.
Your eyeball.
Or my eyeball.
It's been 2 months since jaw surgery, and his forehead is looking amazing. His third eye is gone forever. And first of all, his wife realizes his brain is just fine.
I should buy some regular plates.
Bowl. It feels amazing to be back in
it
together.
I miss her
so
much.
They
have
a
place somewhere.
I do.
Hell yeah, they're still up there on the roof.
Training assist.
Yeah, they need my coffee.
They
might be up there too.
Yeah, we got all those things, all the glass and stuff out packed up.
So we gave it a shot.
In one little box.
Oh, I have a big spoon.
Is that?
Decided to come back the next day. All right. My cyst.
I mean, is that even a little after?
All right, no.
I came back probably 6 days later.
Oh, yeah.
I definitely felt disappointed to know that it wasn't the end of the process yet.
I actually want my nails to enhance my cyst.
Okay, so I'm not going to lie. I was a little excited when it came back. I definitely wanted to get it removed because of the...
You got excited when it came back?
I'm so glad we had this experience together. I know we came in there, especially me.
Like they're best friends who met for the first time ever.
About the procedure.
Oh, what is this?
Yes.
She just...
You not hear their backstory?
To us.
No, I was so trying to battle the bug.
No, that was for the bug. No, that, you were doing text. Basically.
I also have this too.
Yeah, I should use that. But basically,
since Patrick's last procedure, they
met online. There's this online network of people with this stuff.
Did you miss it?
Yeah.
That's not different.
I spoke to Patrick's doctor, and we got permission for Patrick to start.
I mean, nowadays, because, you know,
so I'm really excited to finish the group for everything.
Right. I guess I'm just old.
The thought crossed my mind that Dr. Lee wouldn't be able to.
That ain't that
bad.
Yeah, I just decided to stay positive and move forward.
This is looking really good. I'm very excited.
Wait, you just now trying that?
That is very.
You just now trying the brain food?
It was packed.
Oh.
Under a bunch of shit.
I did a whole nose at one time. That would take me forever.
I would have had it with my breakfast.
I'm sure it's going to be okay.
Welcome to the Late Late Show, folks.
Oh, when I look at my nose in the mirror, it's a lot better than what
I'm glad you sat through our intro
weeks ago.
Right now, we're talking about or watching.
Now that the rhino finally is gone,
got the pimple popper.
This is a small town I've been in, and I've had several people come up to me and say, "Man, you that really looks good."
I hope you were entertained by Brittany's effort to catch the gnat.
Welcome to talk with you.
That's flying around whenever.
Glad you can make it.
See? This is probably where the spider would be alright.
Like going back 15 years.
No, the gnat will not bite. bite me.
No, go through your eye.
Yeah, I'm sure the spider is totally trying to get to my eyeball.
I'm finally relieved that the doctor Lee stuck by me to get this procedure done.
I gave the title
that she's a real caring person.
Of today's, of tonight's program. Since we haven't done like a chat chat, well, I mean, we did a chat the other day, but we haven't done a long one. The title of this is The Why. Car. All right, man, let's pause this. Well, okay, not The Lie. That was the first title. The first title, the original title was The Lie. Now change it to How to Lie and Not Make Yourself Look Like a Dum Dum.
I don't know anything about that.
I know.
I got this one on you.
Man, you're gonna jump in anyway.
Oh, and no, I was just here to not say anything.
Oh, I use a fork. Anyway, so. And also then finish celebrating the story that happened to me, I guess a week ago.
Oh?
I mean, I'm sorry if I never finished it. But basically a week ago during the job, the boss guy put this out there. The boss don't like soft motherfuckers. Okay. Just, I'm not going to say weak, I'm going to say soft. Okay? If you have no... The boss don't like soft serves. How about that?
Alright, I'm not just sure.
For now. But basically, the boss had to work with someone that he usually don't work with, an African dude. We worked before. He was happy to see me. He was the lead. He was happy to see me because, of course, you know, the boss being the boss, he's all strong, or he's all soft. Okay. He wants to move easy stuff and relax. I just want to get the job done so I can go. And, basically, the boss made some mistakes. He takes just a little responsibility. Because sometimes, when someone has problems picking up a 35-pound chair.
35 pounds?
Yeah.
I could put up 35 pounds.
Yes, and telling the boss that it's heavy. Yeah.
Just like a kid?
Yeah.
Yeah. What the hell?
That's all guys these days, you know?
They never... Oh, I guess there's not a lot of dads anymore.
You know, what the interesting, interesting thing that came out today is the U.S. is trying to not... They're trying to find ways so we won't end up going the Japan route. Japan has a situation, they have a crisis. The birth rate over there is extremely low.
Mm.
Yeah.
Well, we're 16 and pregnant, we ain't got no problem.
Well, not anymore because...
We're running out of kids.
No, because now they scare spook where they want to live just a little. Before they end up locking down some kids. Or in some cases, end up murdering them.
Yeah, I watched a documentary about that.
Yeah. But anyway, the boss don't like no softness. And the person you had to work with was soft. Okay? Real soft. Like soft butter. Okay? It was sort of like reverse slavery. Okay? Because strong was supposed to lead the weak. But apparently the weak was leading the strong.
Maybe he one of them Africans from one of them tribes that sent us over here. And that's why he a weak motherfucker. I'm just saying. Nobody talks about this shit.
You're probably right. Because
it's not history month.
Because the boss gave him a raise. The boss gave him a raised eyebrow the second he was like, oh man, I need help with this show. And the boss just,
I could pick up 35 pounds.
Yeah, I mean, it was like a little, like, bench-like chair, and...
Oh.
It wasn't long or anything, he was pretty sure, he just...
I don't understand
it. I don't know either, because, you know, the boss had to move big-ass 100-pound potted plants and put that on his truck by himself. Meanwhile, other dude was horse shitting.
Yeah, I can't pick up a potted plant by myself, though.
No, he couldn't either. And I was going to wait for him, because that's what the boss do. He just works and check out on his partners later to make sure they're not fucking up. Unfortunately, for this time, since the boss realized what he was moving was some light shit.
Yeah.
The boss felt like he didn't need to check on him. He gave him trust.
You regret that?
Man, the boss does. Last weekend in LA, because we're in Los Angeles, it was raining. We got all this weather and all that. I, the boss, did not watch this man set up his truck. He also did not check out what was in these boxes or ask customer what was in these said boxes. I thought my African partner, who was the lead, leading me, had this down, knew how to strap, knew how to do everything A-okay. The boss worked his ass off moving shit. His ass had no shit to move. He had three boxes, a chair, and a bench. Simple. And all you gotta do is put a strap. When the boss got on his truck and moved it, he realized that the box is stupid. Stupid light. And he did not pay no attention because he trusts his little African weak friend.
Ooh.
And so I thought.
Yeah?
Yes. Because I have faith.
I'm sorry, this is work.
Oh, yeah. No, I was letting you type your thing. And while Brittany do that, I'm about to go
get my... I was going to get some food, too.
Damn. Well, I finished talking about my weak friend, or weak... My weak buddy.
You put it back on heat.
Okay.
Oh, somebody tipped me! Yeah!
From what?
Oh, OnlyFans.
Oh.
Cool.
Wow. Remember, folks.
Oh, well, I can show you these. Oh, that was from the other day.
Okay.
That's the one that made my butt cheek hurt.
Remember, folks.
Yeah, look at the drawing.
I'm looking.
Okay, I'm done.
Sorry. Remember, folks, you can catch your girl Britt on my OnlyFans.
So cool. I gotta keep going to the gym though. Gotta get rid of my belly.
You wanna go to the gym tonight after this?
Yeah.
No, I can't. Gotta work.
So don't go to the gym?
I mean, yeah, I guess we can. But for a little bit.
I mean,
at
the very least, I could just sit in the sauna.
Okay.
That's something.
Okay.
I don't have to,
work it out.
Yeah, because I was gonna, practice my freestyle earlier, but I got into moving the stuff, and I was like, well, I'm almost done now. Plus, I'm gonna be doing a modeling thing, so maybe I'll just end up doing it Sunday if that Skype thing doesn't come through.
Anyway.
I'm sorry. I'm talking.
No, you can talk. But anyway. The boss let his weak friend go. He did not expect his truck. He was not being Big Brother boss. Actually, he wasn't being the boss. He was being more like Phil. He'd be alright. I trust him.
Who kiss artistic love to have your Phil jisms on their face. Just saying.
I'm still her fan. Even though she probably haven't been here since.
Man, you saying she, like,
dope. Alright, I'm still his fan, even though, I'm still its fan. Or they fan.
They, them, he, she, them, it.
Yeah.
Human. Could never know.
But the boss let him go. He didn't check his truck. He should have. Because what occurred next, the boss did not see.
That's good. I'm not that he
that's good too.
This is good. Yeah.
It'll be better if I had the other vegetables. But I mean, your self got, they don't need no broccoli. You got carrots and peas.
And corn.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What we eating here is something that I like just came up with. Some quinoa, cranberry chicken sausages, and some carrot peas, string beans. Yeah. All blended together. And I warmed up some cauliflower on the side. Just so, this is my first meal of the day, by the way. No, I had a bowl of turkey. No, a bowl of turkey chili at 12.
So you don't consider that?
I forgot about it.
Because you'd be like, I haven't eaten all day already. What about that big ass thing? Yeah. Like, well, ate something, though.
I'll be forgetting.
Well, you do move a lot, so pretty sure it's burned out by now.
Yeah. But the boss gave his dude fate. He thought he had it. The boss made it all the way to the destination with all 10 pots still on the truck. One of them fell. One of them was poking me to death. And they didn't even know the thing had thorns. I tell you about people with money, because we were helping this gay couple, and they were cool. But man, when you have money, you just don't even see things like thorns on your plants that you water every day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or the homeless.
Yeah, and the boss knew these dudes had money. He knew they had money from some fact that they, and he only knew that because they were talking shit about the place they were in. There's nothing. Penthouses. There's nothing special about having a penthouse apartment or living on a penthouse floor. I was informed that all he did was come up here and take off the number 4 and put PH And then all of a sudden, everything is like a bit higher up here. It's hotter and all that. The rooms are still the same size.
I thought with a penthouse, there's like extra shit you have access to. Like you're really close to the pool if there's one on the roof. And there's usually like a room, like an entertainment room and like random shit like that. So you're on the same floor as all that stuff.
See, their rooms, I want to go see some other rooms because they had where they sleep was downstairs. The living room itself was upstairs.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. That's all I really want to say. Really? Come on, man.
You got two floors. You're not in a shoebox.
Yeah, because when you walk in, you got the kitchen, you got the living room. Then you got to go downstairs. And that's another thing the boss is mad about. The boss was telling this weakling that, hey, there's stairs in this job. You need to add stairs. Okay, I'll do that. All right. They were telling you. No, and they were telling him to add it. You know, the first thing the boss did was like, there's all this downstairs. Right? And the boss said, quote, you know, since there's stairs, you know, we got to add that to the job. I mean, it's just procedure. We just got to do it because if something happens.
I'm pretty sure they didn't really give.
No, because when you have money, you just like, okay, cool, it's fine, whatever. Mm. You're cool. And I was like, all right, awesome. Hey, can you do this? Okay, I will. All right. Gonna do this? Hey. No? All right.
Bring it back?
Yeah, and then they were like, oh, yeah. And then they added stuff, and I was like, hey, are you going to add the stuff? Because on the app.
You didn't add this shit either.
No, on the app Dolly, if the customer have extra stuff, and this is a moving app, and it's extra stuff, that means more money for you, because the more stuff they have, the more it accumulates, the more you get money in your pocket. And this weakling, or this soft man, while I'm telling him to do this stuff, he was like, I will. Or in African accent, I will. But he never did it. And I sat there and waited. Hey, they're telling us, they're trying to hand us more money. That's what they're doing.
He's not very bright.
No.
That's really odd. Like, did he realize, like, hey.
I kept telling him this.
This is more money for more labor.
Yeah, I kept telling him this.
Oh.
And he just like, yeah, just, and the boss was not the lead. When the,
so you couldn't.
No, I can't make no adjustment. I don't know why Dolly decide, because it's an algorithm thing. Let him. So he was like, I haven't done this in a month. Be the lead.
Oh.
And it was all bad because man, I could have made a lot more money because these guys were cool.
I feel like. You should be able to choose, cause I wouldn't want to do that shit. I'd be like, here, you put that shit in. I don't want to leave shit. Like, why would you force me to be a supervisor?
The boss is a little bit supervisors more, but that's how he is.
Yeah, he's not. Enjoy that.
He's not an alpha by choice. He's an alpha by nature.
Oh shit. I like that. It's pretty hot.
Anyway. The ball make it to the customer's house.
Turn this fan on.
You hot?
Yeah.
That light's that hot?
No, it's it got warm when the food was cooking.
Oh yeah.
And now I'm all content.
Well. The boss made it to the place. He met up with the customer, one half of the duel. We talked, we hung out, we put up stuff, we put up the potted plants. I survived the rain.
It rained?
It rained, man, wow. It rained hard.
Oh.
And the one thing I was thinking, like, damn, man, he got freaking boxes. I was thinking about my soft composure. I was like, he got freaking boxes. But, I mean, all
right. Yeah, you got it.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to see that on camera, though.
Well, I saw it.
But the boss was thinking, all right, it's raining. He got boxes. It might be all right. The customer didn't trip because they know it's going to rain. So when me and the one half of the customer duel got there, we did everything. We unloaded everything. And I was like, all right. And I was like, you know what? I'm about to go play some Call of Duty Mobile. And we're going to wait for my partner. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we were just waiting. And, you know, first match, all right, cool. Second match, all right, cool. Third match, man, he's taking an awful lot of time for someone that had left before me.
Yeah.
Fourth match, man, I wonder, did he hit somebody or someone hit him? Mm-hmm. I hope so.
I hope he got hit.
Well, the boss only said he hopes he get hit because it's a good excuse.
That's hilarious.
The boss prayed to the moving gods that this guy got hit. He didn't do the hitting because he had a big ass F-150 truck that's like maybe a few years old.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Yeah, he had a giant vehicle. This is why this whole thing doesn't make sense. But instead, he called the customer, informing him that one of his straps broke.
Oh.
Okay. And he was telling the, and he was explaining to the customer that out of three of the boxes, two of them flew.
Okay, yeah, you did tell me part of this.
Yeah.
Was he driving too fast? Because I feel like even if he wasn't driving that fast, maybe he could have caught it sooner.
So.
I don't know.
So. Here's the ones going down on the 110 freeway all the time, every day, every single month of the day. Except Sundays.
Okay.
Traffic happened on the 110 freeway
no.
by the Staples Center.
Right, because there's always events down there.
Yeah, now there's always events down there. There's people who can't drive trying to hop on the 101. Going either way to get to the 60 or the 10 freeway, or the 5, or they're trying to get to the 101 to get to San Fernando Valley. But everyone crisscrossing, because you got people coming in from 6th Street, you got people on 110, you got people coming in from the 9th Street, the whole bunch of shit be going wrong.
I wouldn't even want to be on right there.
And on top of that, it is raining, it is wet. And the rain was not the light kind of bullshit rain that
we're used to.
Yeah. Okay, we got some bullshit storm, and the boss was worried. Yeah. Lucky for the boss, he had plants, so all the plants did was just get water. So they ain't that's so one less thing that the couple had to do.
Yeah, sort of. You can overwater, but I guess they wouldn't have to water them for a little bit.
Yeah.
That's funny.
But once you pass the 101, you have a chance to punch it and just kick in the gear. Well, no. Once you pass the 110, you got to drive a little. You got to not punch it, but you got to. What's that? You got not riding. When you drive slow. Cruise. You got cruise. Yeah, you got cruise. You got cruise to you get to the 5. Then you punch it.
Okay.
Now, Phil, my little soft friend, the boss feels that he lost his mind. He punched it.
Yeah.
He did not pay attention because when you're moving, especially. You have something that weighs like air in your backseat. The boss feels that he was distracted, and distracted horribly. He was either texting or watching something, and was not looking at his rearview mirror to see what was going on in the back.
Wasn't staring at the world through his rearview.
No, because at some point the boxes just whoosh.
Baby screamed to God. He can't hear you. I can feel your heart beating fast. Guess it's time to die. Getting high, watching time fall.
Yes. Now, the boss had to sit there in horror because yes, it was horror. Because the ball got an eardrop on the conversation that he was having with the customer.
Oh, that sounds fun.
That sounds terrible.
I know.
It's quite possibly the worst conversation you can eardrop on. Yeah. Besides, oh yeah, we need to go handle him. He need to get dealt with. He need to be silenced. Don't trip. I got my people to handle it.
See, I don't know what that's like. I've never had people to handle it.
Now, since customers were Caucasians. Now, since the customers were Caucasian.
They don't have people to handle it.
No, and they keep their cool.
Oh, because they wasn't the Italians. They handled that shit.
All the Russians.
They handled that shit.
Because I felt, because the boss worked with a Russian this past, on Monday of this week, and he felt like this Russian had done some shit. He was not my partner, he was the client. Or, I should say, he was the person that owned the property that my client I was working with was picking up from. And his voice said everything. And his common sense said a lot. Because he was basically calling the customer an idiot and a Chinese man. Chinese man. He's Chinese. In his Russian accent.
Okay. Shit.
Because here's an example. He was telling, oh yeah, once you... Oh, yeah, if you're going to go back down to the car and you got to think of this in a Russian accent, once you take something with you and the dude wasn't understanding, he was like, oh, it's a Chinese man, I don't understand. If you're going down, take something.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because he just did not...
Makes sense to me.
Yeah, he didn't want... I guess he just wanted the stuff out of the house so he can close the door.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I feel like he was a man that handles people. All these did that at some time.
Oh, he probably still did it.
Yeah. But these guys, the customer from last Saturday, no, they are pretty chill. Now, he told them that the strap broke.
Yeah.
The boss knows that's bullshit. And if you're going to sit there and tell a customer...
Lies.
Yeah, lies. You better come up with a better lie.
Good to know. Good to know.
Or find some kind of way to get in some crash.
Well, I don't know if you got to be doing all that.
I get to that in a minute. So he told the customer,
"You need to die."
So the customer told the boss that, my soft friend told him that the strap broke, and the boss knows the strap did not break. That is a lie. Actually, that is a horrible lie. Yeah. It's the worst kind of lie you can say in the situation, because they're going to want to see some evidence of strap broken.
Yep.
just didn't secure it right.
He didn't. It sounds at all. Yes, and that's what the boss feels.
And that's not good.
If you have a $50,000 truck, which that's how much it costs these days.
Oh, damn.
And
it's paid for.
I mean, could have got out of auction. I don't know. But, you know, little guy, big vehicle.
No dick.
Oh, sorry.
It feels that way.
Little dick energy. Da, 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 da. It's a thing.
I was feeling that way. I was feeling that way about my friend, or about my partner that day. Because I'm like, man, you got this big ass vehicle, yet you like butter to me.
No, I got that from not being able to lift 35 pounds, because I could lift 35 pounds.
Yeah.
I'm not buff.
I have to remind my Asian partner, John, that, man, you know, while you're old and struggling, you try.
Yeah.
You try, even though everyone laughs at you.
He's cool, though.
Yeah, but, I mean...
He's a cool dude.
Yes, but everyone give him shit because he's always coughing.
Well, he maybe needs some more tea. Like some hibiscus tea to help. Or does he smoke a lot?
He smokes too goddamn much.
Oh, okay.
He need a dick in his mouth.
Oh, like cigarettes?
Cigars, remember?
Oh, okay.
You know, he loves his dicks. I gotta tell him that. Probably why he's such a fan of black people.
That's why?
Maybe, I don't know.
Do black people smoke cigars a lot?
He hang out at the cigar shop where a lot of them do.
Oh.
I mean, it's kind of their spot, that little lounge. Smoking lounge.
That is interesting.
So.
Seen my bug in a while.
Anyway.
Maybe he gone because I closed the door.
Maybe.
Yeah.
So, what happened after this was my little soft, buttery friend was trying to contact me. The boss did not want to talk to him. At all.
What he contacted you for? He to leave.
Yeah.
He should leave. Himself to a solution.
And leave the boss alone. Because the boss did not want to hear the story. Mm. He just heard the story.
Ah.
He don't know that I'm next to the customer.
Oh, he is not very polite.
No. Because he probably realized, oh, Bill got the heavy stuff. He probably dropped it off and left. But I was sitting there waiting for him because everyone knows I'm the true lead in all these projects. But he called me and told me, Phil. The first phone call, I avoided. The second phone call, well, man, I can't avoid it. Let me just talk to him.
You can't send a message like, hey, no, I'm still here, right? Chill. I need you to chill.
This man was nervous as heck. Oh. He was sitting there freaking out. He was like, oh man. I love it. The boxes are gone. I'm like, dude, this contact Dolly. I'm sure we'll be fine. You know, he told me, you know, I think some homeless man got them. And honestly.
Real specific.
Yeah. to be honest, the boss thing, he punched it, and he punched it right around the river over there, and the boxes just flew into the river because there was no debris, there was no evidence. He was trying to tell the boss that some homeless people picked up the box, and I'll sit there and say, well, man, that's really hard. And and it got me really fast. On top of that, what makes it even more disappointing is he had a big ass vehicle. He could have put these light ass boxes in the back seat of his cab.
That's true. I wonder why he did not do that.
He had room.
And he didn't have a passenger either, right?
No,
so
but
he probably could have put one in the passenger seat, right?
No, but he could have put one of them or even both of them in the back of his cab because it's an F-150. He had a big ass truck.
It's like the one where you could sit
in the back seat.
Oh, okay.
Those are truck cabs. I would love to have a truck like that and not have everything in the front, between the front seat and the back seat.
You will.
Yes. And the cab is all freaking tall and stuff.
You will.
Some people sit there and say size don't matter. Man, that day, size did matter. And it screwed over the dude. So anyway.
Go pee.
I gotta wait for Brittany to come back.
I mean, I appreciate it. You want me to cover this up?
Yeah, cover it up. That's probably where the gnat went.
Nah.
Okay.
But I try to keep stuff covered. I mean, there's some orange peels in that trash can, so it might be over there.
What? Oh.
Yeah, because you put your orange peels in there, so it might be over there.
Well, I'm about to take the trash out anyway.
I definitely gave you a lot of trash.
Around these parts, the boss take out the trash. The boss do a whole bunch of things. I guess Brittany clean. Oh, how so stereotypical. Of Brittany being a borderline. No one can hear your farts out here. Unless you do a nice mean one right now. I don't think Brittany hears me. Ugh. Nope.
These are not matching.
Yeah, they are.
What?
Exactly. She can't hear me.
Oh, yeah, you gotta make sure the toilet, that the thing goes down all the way. Because I guess if you don't do that, the water will keep running in the back of the bowl.
Yeah, I realize that.
Because I messed up earlier today, and I was like, why is this shit still making doors?
Well, at least you know how to cut that off, because a lot of ladies don't.
Oh, yeah, you just gotta lift it till it goes, like, closes. Because I've had that happen before. I mean, as long as it's not snapped. Because then you got to actually dig in there and try to, like, tie something until you can, like...
You know what I mean? Just re-hook it. That's all.
Oh, no, I mean, like, because I've had a snap before, too. Oh. Then you, like, kind of fucked and you actually have to... Yeah, but if it just come off, yeah, just do it.
Oh. Oh. If it does snap, I mean, you can still re-hook it. People don't use paper clips.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
I never thought to do that.
Just using paper clips or staplers. Not staplers.
I don't have staplers.
Like strong, strong staplers.
I don't have paper clips either. I have a safety pin.
Oh, no, you can use safety.
I only have one safety pin. All right, I'll buy some paper clips in case I need to fix the toilet.
Okay. So as I was saying, the first thing he did.
Yeah. No, I can actually go all the way back. Because that's why I left the back down today. Because I wanted to just lean against the wall. Mm-hmm. Kick my feet out.
But the first thing he did wrong was call me to tell me the situation.
Yeah, you incriminate yourself.
Yes. Okay, yes. When, yes, the first thing you need to do when something goes wrong and you got to deal with the customer is you just fess up. Okay? You fess up and you leave it at that and you just walk away. Hey, we fucked up. See ya. That's what you're supposed to do. Don't explain nothing.
That's what I would do, because the fuck else can I do? I'm not a very good liar, so.
The boss, weak assistant, was a little, he went from a soft-ass male to a bitch-ass bitch.
Oh, a bab?
Yes.
Not a babe. Oh, just a bab.
Yeah, he called the boss, freaking out, not for sure what to do, because he lost two of the boxes. Now, he knew what was in those boxes. The boss did not.
Oh. Well, wait a minute, those boxes.
We're going to get to that.
Oh, okay.
But when something goes wrong, you don't call your partners immediately. You sit there and handle the situation at hand, and you don't say nothing. Okay? Reason being, because you're spreading information.
Yeah.
And that information is probably more than likely misinformation when you sit there and start calling and talking. Especially if you're working with a company, because the company might come back and ask you questions about the situation.
Like, hey, this happened. Then you let the app people know this happened. And then you're done.
Yes. You walk away. You sit there. And whatever you told the customer, you stick with it. You commit to it. You don't half measure it. You full measure it. Okay? All right. Because if you ain't going to tell the truth, you're going to bullshit them. You're going to lie. You better stick with it. And you stick to one. Stick to one. Now, the boss had the pleasure of getting an email from Dolly.
Why
didn't you email you into that shit? I know, but I mean, I'm involved. I'm the partner.
Now, you ain't the lead.
I know.
Like, so, have to do with this.
So the last time the boss got hit up by Dolly this way is because of two things. One, the boss got suspended for endangering family for them asking me to do something.
Oh.
And that was the last time. The second to the last time is when one of the dudes, or I should say Latinos, in K-Town saw a nice ass furniture next to a truck and decided to take upon themselves to take the chair and then realize we were moving.
I remember when you told me about that.
And the thing is, the boss was trying to tell not only his partner, but the dumbass customer brother that, hey, somebody need to watch this shit. And the brother said in front of my face, in quote, who's going to steal it? No one wants to steal this. And I told him in response, I will steal this. I will take this. It's on the side of the road. Give it 5 minutes. Someone's going to be here.
Those are rules.
Yes, and sure enough, within 5 minutes, someone was loading up their van, a Latino. He already loaded up the chair. He was trying to load up the bed and had to sit there and take that and make a phone call saying, hey, we have a problem. He took the chair. And the customer, who was sitting there like, ha, 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 cheap ass chair, was like, ooh, this is a $500 chair. Oh, no, he lost my expense. It was so expensive. And we were like, you just said,
I told you. Shit.
And
you ain't lived in the hood, huh? You always have somebody watch the shit.
Yeah.
Always.
Unfortunately, her brother who her little brother, who probably didn't have friends, and probably the closest thing to friends was us, since we're men, and his friends are probably on Twitch, probably on some Twitch talk, sitting there throwing their subs at her.
Tot? Like a tater tot?
A twat? Twitch twat? You know, there was one who said they don't mind the name.
What, twat? Or thought?
Twitch thought.
Twitch thought?
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
Yeah. You know, more profit. I mean, she makes enough money where she can just have that label.
I mean, it was working for you.
Yeah, it worked.
Yeah. I wish something was working for me. God damn.
Well, you're getting tips, so that's a start.
Yeah, but it needs to be more.
So the boss guy reads this email from Dolly.
Yeah.
I don't got my glasses, so it's going to be hard to read. Hi, Phil.
But if you cash app him, it'll be a little bit easier to read.
I don't know if he has a cash app.
But, so let me zoom in. And this is from I'm from Dolly, from Mike Frizzell.
That is a dope name.
Mike, M-I-K-E, Frizzell.
Frizzell.
F-R-I-Z-Z-E-L-L.
Yeah, I like it.
And he said, "Hi, Phil. This is to notify you that a damage claim has been initiated by the customer for the Dolly in a subject line. Please know that this email does not mean you're currently being held at fault, blame, or at fault blame for causing any damage at this time. They better not.
Yeah, no shit.
We are simply informing you that the report has occurred. The incident is under review. And we are requesting any additional information you may have.
We cover our ass.
The additional information is confession video.
You gonna snitch?
Technically, yeah. As soon as possible, please reply. Please reply all of any additional info or evidence for the claims department to include in their review. Do not
snitch.
Do not call to discuss without first submitting a written response and reply to this email. So, let me tell you my response. Good morning. Well, I don't know what to say since none of my items flew off the truck. And the customer said I was in the clear since I delivered his items. We shook hands. He let me go. That's all.
I ain't do shit, bitch.
What the fuck you got back to me for it?
Yes, all right. if no response to this message, which I'll think about not responding because that's not
important. Then they probably trying to.
Yeah.
Hey, you didn't respond, so you must have done something wrong.
If no response to this message had been received within 3 days, 72 hours, from the day it was sent, we will move forward with the claim based on the information we have gathered. I'm still not involved. Once the claim has been reviewed and processed, any amount paid or refunded to the customer as a result of this claim may be withheld from your pay.
I do not.
Yes, but the boss had to say something. Because my weak bitch ass chump alicious of a partner screwed up. And this letter gonna sit there and like I said, what I said at the beginning, if you gonna bullshit, if you going to lie, you stick with it, you commit to it, and you take it like a motherfucking man. You bend over, you just take it and just be like, alright, I'm cool. Now, what was said? What is the item that was damaged?
Well, how would you know that?
I know.
You didn't do nothing.
Under California law, AB 5.
Oh, fuck this shit.
The helpers are employees of Dolly.com.
You employee now or you're hourly?
I know. And as a result, Dolly.com is responsible for 2 wardrobe boxes stolen during this local move.
Stolen?
I know. That's what I'm saying. If you're going to bullshit, you stick with it. It's going to keep getting better.
What?
It's going to keep getting better. As noted in the report filed on 2/24, February 24th, with the Los Angeles Police Department, the value of the stolen item, which the boss did not know of, exceeds $10,000. It had to be art in these wardrobe boxes.
Oh, that's bad, because that could be a felony then, right?
He didn't steal them.
No, I'm just saying, because they saying stolen.
No. It's going to keep better.
That's scary.
The helper claimed 2 wardrobe boxes fell out of the truck. Impossible. Impossible. Because if one fall, they all fall. That can't happen. They flew. He drove, air caught it, and they just launched up in the air. And he probably didn't catch it. The helper claimed 2 wardrobe boxes fell out of the truck on California Highway 110 North, or 110N. The helper has secured the boxes with a moving strap that was undamaged.
This nigga's stupid.
We have pictures of the strap.
He dumb. Why he say it was a strap?
Yes. No, we ain't done yet. The helper story changed 3 times upon questioning.
Man, what the hell do a judo?
No, they just telling me the story.
Why even sending you this shit? They gossiping on their own shit.
No, because they wanted me to know, okay?
Just so you know.
The helpers. See, they should.
Don't include me. See, I didn't do nothing.
See, they use plural. This is plural, right?
Yeah.
This is plural. It's supposed to be singular.
Say singular. I ain't do
the helper, not helpers. I'm not involved.
My shit was fine.
Yes, but the helper's story changed 3 times upon question. The boss didn't get questioned, because if the boss got questioned, he would have said, dropped all my shit. Customer said, we cool.
We straight.
But the helper's story changed.
I'm not even the lead.
The helpers. I got to read this as the helper's stories changed 3 times upon questioning. Initially, story number 1. The helper, the helper stated, he was in the left lane of the highway and the 2 boxes flew out.
Okay.
Crashing onto the highway.
Well, okay. Because if that happened, there would be clothes everywhere, right?
Well, or whatever that came out of it.
Whatever was in it would be like everywhere. Yeah.
And he would have caught it. Or he would have saw it. But then again, these boxes was light. Now.
That's, I feel like that would have made a noise, though.
Yeah, crashing onto the freeway. He said crashing. All right. Then, the helper stated he was in the center lane and heard a loud noise indicating something had fallen. So he went from the left lane to the center lane. Finally, 3. The helper stated that was in the right lane. Yes. Left.
Why are you switching lanes on the motorcycle? Like, that's gonna make a difference.
Yes. Yes.
Oh my God.
Finally, the helper stated he was in the right lane of the freeway, of the highway.
You don't know what lane you was in.
When he heard a loud noise,
he didn't hear shit. No. The shit was gone. He noticed too damn late.
Yeah.
He could have just said that. I don't know when that shit flew off, but the shit flew off.
Yeah.
Damn.
If he did that, and that's the thing. So let's go back to when the helper was, when he was in the left lane. Now, if he was in the left lane, then yes. And I'm pretty sure he probably told the story to someone, and someone said, hey, you can't be, if you were in the left lane, there would still be some evidence of the box somewhere on the freeway, because he went back to search for them. And there would be some kind of, somebody would have hit it, or cars would not hit it, but they would have just went around it. Mm-hmm. Someone would have done something, but I'm pretty sure he didn't realize until it was too late. So that's what happened with the left lane. It was a left lane, it would have just fell off. The next car behind it would have hit it, and the other cars would have just went around it, and it would stay like that until someone got out of the vehicle and moved the damn box, or a CHP came over and moved it and just left it on the side of the road for whoever, and owns it, or whoever, to grab it.
Hmm. Right.
This logic also applies to the middle lane. In the middle lane, it would be even safer because everyone would just avoided it. It is possible. Now, since the boxes are light, since the boxes are light, if this big-ass vehicle now was behind them, they would have hit it and just kept pushing because the box was going to stop. And if the sub exceeded $10,000, which was art, there would have been something on the freeway. Now,
okay, we have no random ass people move your $10,000 shit, though.
Well, that's
I mean, just personally, if I had some shit worth $10,000, I would probably, pay the extra money to have professionals.
Well, we're supposedly professionals. And we're supposedly employees, which I did not know.
AB5, nigga.
I have not been informed.
AB5. You're an employee. AB5. They gonna get you sooner or later. AB5. Fucking up everyone's shit.
Yeah, so the boss work for the man now. Finally, the helper stated that he was in the right lane of the freeway when he heard a loud noise. Mm-hmm. These boxes would have never made no noise. But, mm-hmm. However, if he actually said this in the beginning, it would have made more sense. Because, in each version, the helper then claimed that he pulled off the highway near Avenue 43. And another motorist flagged him down to tell him a homeless man had moved the boxes to the side of the road.
Oh.
Then a second motorist told the motorist that a homeless man had taken the two 50-pound boxes over a 6 to 8 foot fence.
That fast? I mean,
yeah.
What kind of, is that like a fucking worker ant?
I guess.
Wait, how tall is this fence?
6 to 8 foot.
And he just got it over,
And that's the thing, 50 pounds. A 50-pound wardrobe box would not be easy for some homeless man.
And two of them.
Yeah.
By itself.
Yeah, and not that fast.
And two different people saw it.
Yeah. And
people ain't that nice.
Yeah.
Not to be an asshole, but people aren't that nice. You might be lucky if one person's like, hey, your shit flew off. Just so you know. Bye.
The boss not for sure if the motorist thing happened.
I don't think that shit happened. It's too much. It's way too complicated.
And also, there are people living on the side of the 101 freeway.
Yeah.
There is nobody living on the side of the 110 freeway, the cops won't allow it.
But there might be people living inside the 101 freeway, like Bray Wyatt or the Fiend, and they pop out when boxes fall on the freeway and they just suck your shit down to hell. I think that's what happened here.
It's possible. We have pictures.
What?
We have pictures of the fence.
We have pictures. We're holding your wardrobe ransom.
The story reported by Dolly's employee, the helper, is inconsistent and impossible.
It's impossible to me, and I don't move shit, and it sounds like bullshit. It's like, yes. Wait, what?
Yes.
This so, way too complicated.
Yeah, so here's the thing. This, my weak partner of the day, I would not want to do a crime with him. Because
he will fuck up all your shit.
He will not only crack, he will then stick to the story. He is a person that I'll probably get the Russian dude that I was dealing with on Monday to handle him. And handle him and to make it look like an accident.
Yeah, don't do crimes on me either. I'm too honest.
Yes.
Don't tell me nothing.
And the boss wish, and that's another thing. When something goes wrong, you sit there and say, hey, you call your partner and tell him something wrong, it's on me. That's it. No extra, no story. When you start telling a story and trying to make yourself believe it, everybody gonna think crazy. Like these guys here at Dolly, because they think this dude is crazy. Because they straight up said, the story reported by Dolly's employees, the helpers, singular, I'm not involved, singular, not no plural shit. I ain't do shit. I delivered my items. The customer was cool with me. We shook hands. He told me to go.
With me.
Don't put me in this beef. All right?
They want you to get the smoke.
But report about the Dolly's employee, which I did not report. I did not call these guys. Because what the fuck I'm going to tell them? Hey, I dropped off my shit, but man, this dude, I don't know.
He I lost the box. Yeah.
Yes, it's like, they did call me and ask me for a story because the customer already said, hey, he's cool. But as I said, the story reported by the Dolly employee, the helper, I won't say helper, not helpers, the helper, is inconsistent and impossible. I never even heard.
And impossible.
Yeah, I never even heard of a business straight up say impossible. That show you the people that we were dealing with. They're young. I'm pretty sure I'm older than all of them. Because no one will sit there and put, they will say inconsistent, but they never say inconsistent and impossible.
Yeah. This impossible whopper.
We have reported this as stolen property to the police, including Dolly's information as well as the helper's helper, not S. Okay, let's show you how young they are. We intend to hold Dolly fully responsible. Can't prove the value of the contents. See, I feel like there's something supposed to be there. No, we intend to hold. Yeah, we intend to hold Dolly fully responsible, can prove the value of the contents, and will sue Dolly in California State Court if this matter is not.
Who wrote this shit?
Yeah.
Man, Frizzle. You fucking up. Frizzell.
Yeah. But I got finished reading this. We intend to hold Dolly fully responsible. I feel like this is like the customer area. And, not because it's as if they're talking about them, what they're going to do, what the customer is going to do to them. I don't know. Or far as like this is a customer statement, or you know, we have reported this as stolen property to the police, including Dolly's information as well as the helper. Because I ain't get no phone call. We intend to hold Dolly fully responsible, can prove the value of the contents, and will sue Dolly in California State Court if this matter is not resolved immediately. See, I feel like that was the customer's lawyers. And they probably got some young lawyer that didn't know. I don't know. We will also cooperate with the police in a full investigation and prosecution of all individuals involved, including, without limitations, the helpers. Helper. Not furs. Fur. It seems like I'm about to get caught in a case.
Like, wait, y'all saw me there. I didn't do shit.
Pictures are attached. You'll be notified as soon as the claim is complete. And I need to look at the pictures.
Because, like, do they have you take pictures of your shit, too?
Huh?
Like, do they have you take pictures of your stuff before you leave and when you get back?
No. Okay, so...
So that, you know, in case something like this happens, like, okay. All the shit got here.
So, here's the picture.
Right.
This is how the dude packed. Now, from the looks of it, it doesn't look like there's a strap on there.
I don't see no strap.
Okay, so let me show. Apparently, a customer, or not a customer, someone is driving a car, and good for them, a motorist, got basically a photo of this dude's truck.
So he probably didn't even notice
the shit flew off. Yeah, so that's the table that I put on, or like the little chair thing that I put on there myself, and those are the boxes.
No strap.
There was no strap. He's supposed to do on the back of a truck. You're supposed to do a crisscross. I mean, he's supposed to make an X with the boxes to make sure it's secure. And you got this big ass truck. He was thinking it'll be fine. The thing is, what you're supposed to do. You can move stuff while using straps as long as you're going less than 5 miles away from where you're driving from.
Your wand never flew out of there.
Your wand got weight. But apparently your wand weighs more than 50 pounds because that's what this guy used. Or the customer said it weighs. I don't know.
That's all right, bullshit, because I know my wands don't weigh no damn 50 pounds. They ain't never flew out of your truck, and they don't be strapped down. I'm even more confused by this.
Yes, but my partner...
The fuck?
But by zooming in, my partner did not have straps on this at all.
Maybe it caught too much air.
Yeah, it got caught too much air, and... You know, because it's holes in the sand, it lifted off.
Oh, shit, yeah. I just noticed that.
So, and I got to see the other photo, because this is the boss first time seeing the photo. He didn't look at the photos earlier. Hmm. Okay. All right, and the police report. Hmm. Oh, and they, what's his name? Grand Theft. This is considered Grand Theft? Okay. Well, no, I don't know.
No, not auto. Not GTA 5.
Yeah, but this is... No, but this is the name of the customer. And his information. Oh, man. See, the occupation attorney.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, that's pretty bad.
Oh yeah, I mean it's kinda hard, trying to bold. So I did not know the customer's occupation. But the customer occupation is lawyer.
Officer, what, everybody.
So besides the whole suing,
it's, oh, your dick is going to pay.
Besides the whole, you know, lawyer thing, I think lying to the lawyer or even saying anything.
Yeah. Just as admissible.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, fucked himself over with his own shit.
Yeah. It, and this is, whenever you do this, commit to it and say, hey, I lost it. It flew. I'm about to drop the stuff off. You go talk to Dolly or whoever, and y'all figure it out, okay? I'll just tell you now, it flew. And I'm not even sure what's going to happen to the dude, because either he's suspended or he's getting dropped indefinitely since, well,
that's a lot of money.
Yeah, and they find his story inconsistent and impossible, okay? Because he kept switching the story. And it's true, you can't switch lanes, but the fact that there's a picture of the wardrobe box. And the wardrobe box is pretty tall. And from the looks of it, it doesn't look like there was any straps on the vehicle itself. Okay? He could have put one of those boxes in the back of his truck, but he did not. And that's the thing. I don't know the true value. And I'm pretty sure there was art in these wardrobe boxes. But I don't know the true value of it because they didn't let me know. Alright, they just know that I was moving the pots and plants. You know, the boss doing the heavy shit. His ass was, no, I'm weak. You know, he had, like, easy shit.
Well, he did at least not lost it.
Or pay attention where it flew on the freeway. Because even then, even if you're flying, all right, and something flies out like a box, you will stop immediately. And you won't follow where that box goes. It's as if, I feel like,
think he noticed.
No, that's the thing.
It's a very big box.
Yes. See, yeah, it's the wardrobe box that flew. And it was two wardrobe boxes. The thing is, he had the heaviest one in the back, which was full of clothes, and the other two in the front. And he was probably blasting some music, talking to someone, you know, on Pornhub. Distracted, or you know, on Cheddar Bay, looking at that anime broad, because there's no way
that PS2 graphics,
yeah, because there is no way in hell that his story. Even during like the apocalypse, would it make sense?
Yeah, he fucked up. He fucked up. Oh shit, that's pretty fucking awful.
I need to go back to the original email one more time.
Yeah.
No, not you.
Huh. I didn't give you a name.
Yes, you did. Fluffy Puffy.
I don't think that sounds like me. It would have been
Huffy Puffy.
Huggle Puffy the Third or something.
No, but you gave that name.
Number and Puff.
You did that year. How do I remember it?
Huffy Puffy is not a name I would give.
You gave this goddamn thing that.
Fluffigans.
Now it's Fluffigans? You know there's video evidence of you saying this, and in a year you won't change it again.
Good. Then the name will be Bob.
Fluffy Bob?
No, just Bob.
But making me look like a dumb dumb because I can remember these names and you don't.
That's impossible. anything. That shit ain't got nothing to do with you. And he fucking, man. Yeah, he fucked himself over.
Yeah, so, folks, when it comes down to working with customers and something go wrong, especially if you don't know their attorney, don't tell them nothing. Just say, hey, I lost your shit. Talk with Dolly. Sorry.
Yeah, because, well, my brief time on apps, the motherfuckers made a complaint against me. I wasn't like, oh, you're absolutely right.
Yeah.
Like, look, this is what I did. If it wasn't good enough for you. They said it was cool when I left, and I asked them several times, hey,
yeah,
is it good? So, I don't know why the fuck you got a problem now. Day later, but whatever.
And that's the thing with the whole attorney thing. Because, the customer were cool peeps. They were cool. But I don't know what kind of attorney they are. I don't know if they're a baby face or a heel attorney.
That's true.
All right. Because given their business, they got to do what they got to do. And, you know, being the heel, there's a whole lot of money in being a heel attorney.
Yeah. You
need
to have $10,000
wardrobe. Or, no, remember, it's not $10,000. They said over $10,000. They can't say, oh, that's the thing. They can't say over five figures. They have to give a number. So, I don't even know the true value of what the fuck was in there. Because it could be $30,000 to $40,000 to even $50,000 and up. Because it felt like, since the box was light, it felt like it was art. Oh,
that's pretty bad. Because you can't really, like, if it's like certain shoes and clothes, that shit you can replace. But art is kind of more subjective. Oh. What if it's some rare shit?
Yeah. And
Yeah,
and I never saw what was in the boxes because they were just boxing it up. You know, I was just focused on the plant and maybe. And that's what the boss goof. The boss goof because he ain't checked this weekly.
He's a lead.
Yeah, he's a bad lead. There's people that shouldn't be the lead, because especially when the boss is there, because he's
didn't
always.
Make that choice. Dolly did. That's their employee.
Well, I'm their employee too.
Okay, they make you the lead, so.
Yeah.
You gotta learn.
Yeah, well, I'm pretty sure this dude is getting kicked off.
Probably.
I mean, because since they never said a number, they gotta use over, like, a certain amount, so over $10,000.
Like, he lost a pair of drawers from fucking H&M.
I'm pretty sure the person I was working with wished that.
That'd be a lot of underwear to be. Oh shit, he's gonna have half the store stock of underwear. That's fucking awful.
Yeah. But anyway, you know what? Me and Brittany had some fun tonight, and we about to go hit the gym before it gets too late. You know, I've been up since 4 this morning. Didn't take a nap or anything.
You should go to sleep.
Yeah, but I mean, go.
I mean, I could go in the morning. I'll just get up earlier so you can sleep. Yeah, I think you should sleep.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, what time do we have to leave?
Probably like 8. Because you gotta be there at 10, right?
Yeah.
And it'll probably take.
Go to your sister's
place.
Okay.
Yeah, tomorrow will be my last day to go to the gym before I actually gotta start paying the bill. The boss got all kind of bills since he's behind on bills. Behind. No, like 7.
At 7? Okay.
Yeah, like 7 or 7:30. Get up and just goes. You're not going to get up and start getting yourself together while taking a shower first.
Okay. Well, I have clothes picked up, so I just got to put that in the robe in the bag. And
you should put that in the bag now so you don't know how to do that in the morning.
I'd rather do it in the morning so I can make sure I have everything. Because sometimes when I do it the night before, I don't have all the stuff and it's in the brain. But that's why I put it aside so that I would know to bring that. Hey. I just need a pair of socks.
And do you have any bowls here?
No, that's what I said. Yeah. I either gotta buy some.
Oh, I gotta move the one. Yeah, but I was wondering.
You were saying, like, yeah, all the stuff. I'm like, oh no, I had a few cups.
Yeah, yeah.
A few things.
I still in the process of moving stuff. So. Yeah. I was hoping you had any more Rubbermaid bowls anywhere. I would like to eat some cereal. No, don't buy none that you already have.
Well, I don't have a billion bowls either. I have like maybe four, maybe.
Yeah,
it's really not a lot. I don't have a lot of dishes.
And I got one.
I think I have a few plates.
No, you got some glass plates. It's just I just need to go out there and get them. But yeah, the boss really, he needs a sleep. I was going to, I had the energy to play some rhythm games tonight, but I came in. Yeah, oh, wait.
I think you should rest, you've been up.
Yeah, now I'm sore.
Yeah, you need to sleep.
Boss is out.
Yeah. Good night, everybody.
Hope you enjoy how to lie and not look like a dum-dum from my story today.
You too can avoid prison.
No, so you can avoid not like losing lawyer shit because they're gonna be better at their argument and they're gonna win every time.
Yeah.
Man, since that dude's an employee, man, he's gonna get fired. And they're telling him he's responsible. You're enslaved to work with us for life.
Yeah.